Hello students, good morning everyone. Hope you all are good. So today we'll be discussing about fission, fine? That is one of the type of asexual reproduction. So students, for unicellular organism, cell division or fission leads to the creation of new individual. Like many different pattern of fission have been observed. Like many bacteria and protozoa, they simply split into two equal halves during cell division. So first of all, we should know that what exactly do we mean by this term, that is fission. So fission is an asexual reproduction by which a unicellular organism divides. Remember, I am talking about unicellular. And forms two or more new individual. Fine. So with the help of one, two or more than two can be formed. This is what they are saying. So they are binary fission and multiple fission. Fission means to break down something, fine, to break something. And fission, it is of two types here. First one is binary fission and second one we have is multiple fission, fine. So students, now what is binary fission here? Binary means two. Remember this thing, binary means two. So in this method, an organism divides and forms two individuals. Fine. So how this division occurs? First the nucleus divides and forms two nuclei. Then the cytoplasm divides and forms two daughter cells. The example you can see is amoeba and paramecium. So how does this takes place? You all can see here. Fine. See, this is the structure of amoeba. You all can see. First the nucleus will divide. So you can see a nucleus here. It will start dividing. Then ultimately your cytoplasm also start dividing and it results into the formation of two daughter cells. You all can see here. Fine. Now when I am telling you multiple fission, so in this method one organism divides into many daughter cells. Fine. One organism divides into many daughter cells. Like we have a single celled organism only, for example malarial parasite. Fine. That is the plasmodium. Fine. It is the malarial parasite plasmodium. Now students, it divides into number of daughter cells, fine, simultaneously by multiple fission. This is what the plasma, this multiple fission is. You all can see here, fine, the cyst has been formed, okay, and you can see there results into the formation of many daughter cells within. Finally the cyst breaks, fine, and they can actually, you can see that if difference between binary fission and multiple fission comes, so I'll be explaining you the difference as well, fine, in the form of tabular form. You can simply write it down. One would be the definition, examples, fine, and what exactly happens in case of binary fission and in case of multiple fission. Although students, however, some unicellular organisms show somewhat more organization of their body, such as for example in Leishmania, fine, I would like to rub it for you. For example in Leishmania, which cause Kala Azar, it is a disease, fine, the disease is caused by Leishmania, which have a whip like structure at one end of the cell, fine. So in such organism, binary fission occur in a definite orientation only in relation to these structures. Alright students, now coming on to the next that we have is budding. Okay, budding is the next one. So organisms such as Hydra use regenerative cells for reproduction in the process of budding. So in Hydra what happens, you all can see here in this matter, bud like projection is formed on the body of the organism. This is what the bud is, fine. Now a bud develops as an outgrowth due to repeated cell division at one specific site. So you can see here at this very specific site, fine, there is a repeated cell division. There is repeated cell division due to which you can see bud has appeared, fine. So these buds develop into tiny individual and when fully mature, they detach from their parent body. So you can see here, fine, slowly and gradually they become an independent individual. For example, budding in Hydra, budding in yeast. Yeast is also another example of this thing, fine. So the same thing happens with yeast as well. Fine. So there is a bud that has been formed. It keeps on dividing. Fine. This is how the process takes place. So in your exam, both the examples can come. Fine. So remember this thing. In these two, budding takes place. Fine. Budding is a mode of asexual reproduction, bache, in which what happens? A small bud, that is due to the repeated division, basically a small bud appears here, then develops into a new individual and separate from the main parent body. Coming on to the next one that we have is regeneration. Fine. Now students, many fully differentiated organisms have the ability to give rise to new individual organism from their body part only. Remember this thing, from their body part. Like you can see here, in this method, a part of the body of the organism is cut. For example, if the body of organism is cut or broken, so that broken part can give rise to a new individual. For example, this takes place in hydra, starfish, planaria. Fine, hydra, you can see the example of hydra, and this is the example of planaria. The purple colored structure you can see here is the planaria. So you can see there are some special cells, bache. Fine, there are some special cells, fine, with the help of which this thing takes place. Now, you all can see here, this is a complete organism, fine. And if its body is cut or broken, fine. So you can see it has broken into three pieces accidentally. Now each piece gives rise to a complete planaria. And this is what the same thing happens here as well, fine. Amputation takes place, it has been cut into two portions. So now regeneration will happen from the broken part. The special cell will regenerate. So you can see they will grow, and this results in the again hydra. This is what the process is. So if individual is somehow, I am talking about somehow, fine, if they cut or broken up into many pieces, so many of these pieces grow into separate individual, fine. For example, we have discussed in hydra and planaria. I hope this thing is clear, bachche. And regeneration is carried out by a specialized cell. So you need to remember this thing, they are basically carried out by a specialized cells, fine. So these cells proliferate and make large number of cells. So what happens on this side, these are the cells, specialized cells that are present. I would like to show it to you with blue color. Here the specialized cells are present, bache. These cells proliferate and make the larger number of cells, fine. And from this mass of cell, different cell undergo changes to become various types of cells and tissue, and these changes takes place in the organized sequence, fine. However, bache, regeneration is not the same as reproductions, since most of the organism would not normally depend on being cut up to be able to reproduce, fine. So it is not that it is not much considered to be the part of asexual mode of reproduction. But why is it so? Because bache, no organism, because there are most of the organism, they would not be like normally depending upon being cut. It is something that is accidental, fine. I hope this thing is clear. So this is what all about regeneration. Now comes fragmentation, bache, fine. So in multicellular organism with relatively simple body organization, simple reproductive methods can still work. For example, you all can see here, this is a spirogyra. In this method, the body of a simple multicellular organism, remember this thing, it breaks up into smaller pieces. So you all can see here, fine, and this give rise to a complete individual. So the name of this asexual mode is fragmentation. So if a body is actually dividing, fine, dividing into smaller pieces, so what happens on maturation, each fragment develops into a new individual. I hope this thing is clear. Now what happens, spirogyra simply breaks up into smaller pieces upon maturation. So what is the difference between this fragmentation and regeneration then? Regeneration is something accidental. There are specialized cells are present, but no specialized cells are present in case of fragmentation. Fine. It actually works when a body matures. Remember this thing. But that's completely accidental. Fine. So now what happens? These species or fragments grow into a new individual. Now students, remember this thing. This is not true for all multicellular organisms. Okay? They cannot simply divide cell by cell. The reason is that many multicellular organisms, as we have seen, are not simply a random collection of cells. Specialized cells are organized as tissue, and we know this thing. See, Why the fragmentation doesn't take place in multicellular organism? Because in multicellular organism, you know that cell combine to form the tissue. Tissue combine to form the organ. Organ combine to form the organ system. Fine. So I hope this thing is clear. Okay. So in such a carefully organized situation, cell by cell division would be impractical. Fine. That is why multicellular organism therefore need to use more complex way of reproduction. That we are going to study later on. That is sexual reproduction. Fine. So I hope this thing is clear to each one of you. This was all about today's module. Thank you, students.